do it, we are starting off with the Seattle Seahawks. 12-4 last season. And, of course, there was all of the rumblings going on about Russell Wilson, what's going to happen with him and Pete Carroll. This team has moved on from the Legion of Boom over to a much more offensive-minded team, I guess you could say. They got rid of Shoddy. Everything's good there, I hope, unless it's Pete Carroll's decision to run the ball more. I don't know. But the Seahawks obviously did pretty well last year, 12-4, won the division. They only had three picks in this year's draft. Their needs, per the online constituency, was offensive tackle, cornerback, defensive tackle, center, and wide receiver. They had three picks, and they had them in the second, fourth, and sixth rounds. They took wide receiver D'Wayne Eskridge out of Western Michigan with their second-round pick. Fourth round, they took cornerback Tre Brown out of Oklahoma. And offensive tackle in the sixth round, Stone Forsythe out of Florida. I don't hate this at all. The only thing that I don't like is the lack of picks, right? They did nothing to try and take a few more bites at the apple, as we have said. But, you know, Tre Brown, while he's undersized, he has obviously put up big performances. D'Wayne Eskridge from Western Michigan, like, this is a bit of a reach, but he's a kid that absolutely produced in the MAC. And Stone Forsythe, I mean, that's a flyer kind of guy. Like, I'm totally fine with this. I think it was okay for what they had. They utilized their picks to the best of their ability, in my opinion. They just didn't have a lot of them.
Right. And if I told you, okay, so they didn't have a first-round pick, so I throw Jamal Adams in there. And then they didn't have a third-round pick because that was also for Jamal Adams. So you get a Jamal Adams player for a first and a third. I'm not going to argue with that. The dude's an absolute beast. What, 9.5 sacks? It's the third most ever for a defensive back. And, I mean, he's the modern-day Ronnie Lott. He really is. And then you look, they traded their fifth-round pick for a Pro Bowl guard in Gabe Jackson. Love that. If you told me a team's drafting Carlos Dunlap in the seventh round, who had 5.5 sacks in 8 games, I'm going to be like, you just got the steal of the draft. So even though they didn't have a ton of picks, what they got for their picks makes their team exponentially better. So it's hard to grade the actual picks. D'Wayne Eskridge, everything I read about this guy, he's just an all-purpose guy. He can return kicks, catch it out of the slot. He's going to be another Tyler Lockett-type player for Russell Wilson, which is perfect because the dude is, again, going to be running for his life. His offensive line's not good there. We know that for a fact. He's going to be running for his life. And, you know, a quarterback's best friend's one of these quick little guys who can run these short routes and turn nothing into something. So I do like the pick there. Tre Brown, everything I've read about him out of Oklahoma, fantastic young corner. That Seattle secondary was abysmal the first half of the year. They definitely got better the second half of the year once Adams came back from that shoulder injury, et cetera. It's hard to rate it because it's three picks, but what they got for their draft picks, I think, were quality players. So overall, I give Seattle a passing grade. I like what they did with their picks. I like the impact players they got. And it's hard to argue against Jamal Adams, Carlos Dunlap, and Gabe Jackson for your draft picks, in my opinion. So, yeah, I like what Seattle did, and I think they'll be a little bit better next year despite Russell Wilson's whining and pouting. By the way, probably my least favorite player in the NFL is Russell Wilson. This is you remember that movie Draft Day where none of the kids went to the 21st birthday. You know why that was in the movie? Because that actually happened to Russell Wilson. He's a faker. He's a joker. The holy water on the sidelines to hear a concussion. Get the hell out of here.
You were trying to
virgin get till I marry. Like what the hell is this 1912? Like get the hell out of here, Russell Wilson. He bugs the living crap out of me. But Seattle's going to be better next year. And I do kind of like what they did with this draft.
You're trying to get the Seahawks fans fired up at us. I know what you're doing. Yeah, you're being the antagonist. I know, and I get it.
But I'm a 49er fan.
How can you not enjoy Mr. Unlimited?
No, I can't do that. I can't do the Mr. Unlimited thing.
Jump on in here, Chris. Tell me what you think.
All right, so we're going to disagree on this draft. I think this is one of the worst drafts in the NFL. Out of all the things, I think they did a bad job. A, because when you give up three draft picks for one player, while I love that player, I don't get to just immediately slot that player in for your first-round pick because it cost them two first-round picks and a third-round pick. So I'm not giving them credit for Jamal Adams there. Okay. Their only pick, first-round pick, or the first pick that they had in the second round, I think they took a wide receiver. I think there were better wide receivers that went behind this kid, much better. You want to talk about a guy, a team that could have picked up speed? My Cleveland Browns drafted Anthony Schwartz. I'm going to tell you this. That's who Russell Wilson needed right there. If you put skinny Schwartz next to monster DK, there's nobody that can guard that. All right. You got the two fastest guys in the NFL at that moment in time, and nobody's covering you. I just think they missed on their wide receiver pick. I'm not a fan. Tre Brown, I don't know enough about Tre Brown, but I know this. Every time Oklahoma played a good offense, they gave up points. They gave up a lot of points. And so I have to assume that Tre Brown wasn't locking down one side and they were just picking on the other side. I have to assume that against LSU, when they gave up like 19 touchdowns the playoff year before, that Tre Brown was getting dusted right and left. These are NFL guys, okay? I understand that not a lot of NFL wide receivers came out of the Big 12, and so last year you might have looked really good, all right? But when you played against other NFL wide receivers, which is what you're going to have to do in the league, you didn't look great. So I'm not a fan of that pick either. Stone Forsythe, okay, you took an offensive lineman from Florida, probably not a bad pick. He's a sixth-round pick. He might make the roster. He might help the team. I don't know. That's a flyer. I'm not going to knock that pick. But the other two, you don't get credit for. I think they were bad picks because the wide receiver, there's no matter how good he can be. Seth Williams and Anthony Schwartz went behind him. Seth Williams went way, 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 way behind him. He's going to be light years better than this guy.
I love that. I love bagging the Seahawks. I love anything bad about the Seahawks. So that makes me
very, very happy. You took a kid that's 5'9", and you got a 6'1 and 6'2 guy behind him. And both of those guys are unbelievably much faster. So
there you go.
Yeah, screw the Seahawks. You're right. Their draft sucked. You're right. Their Seahawks suck.
Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com. And if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at Chris B. Giannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.